Hi, I'm Stephanie, and I'm having coffee with Pastor Deb.
Hi, Stephanie. It's good to be with you.
Well, I heard the sermon last week, so we were going to talk, but it was just about love, love, love. You know, it was like, okay, I'm a big believer in love, but we were talking about different kinds of love and that kind of stuff like that. I wanted to get to know you a little bit better, you know, since you're new and everything, but so tell me a little about love in your family.
You know, love in our family could be a little messy at times. I come from a large family. And I referenced in the 5 months that I've been with St. Paul Presbyterian Church, It's always a privilege and it's fun to think about the ways that you've experienced things in your faith at different ages and stages. And love is, we love each other very much as a larger family, but brothers and sisters at times, sibling rivalries at times, disagreements at times, different views, but we are committed in the ways that my parents loved us to continue loving each other.
How many children are there in your
family?
My
folks were busy. They had 5 kids.
And how many do you have?
I only have 2 boys, so I'm a little more sane. They're
sane.
In their 20s.
I don't know about children. Once you've had those, I don't know if that counts for that.
It's the blessing, and it just keeps on giving, as my mom said, about 5 of us. So, but my parents have passed now, and we, in the latter stages of their lives, we learned a lot about love, because it's hard to have your parents' health fail. And all of the siblings came together and did what they could do to be a part of caring for them in those later years.
I have kind of a different end of this. Let's see. I raised 2 children, my niece and nephew first, and then, because I never thought I'd get married, then Mr. Dennis came along, and 23 years later, we're still together.
That's awesome.
And I have 2 adopted children that are wonderful, Jonathan and Kate, and it has been another experience of having 2 children again. So, and now they're 20 and 21, and we're at the time where they're like going off into the world, and we're getting our lives back. Kind of. They're still living at home, and you know, those first jobs and going to college, but with the pandemic, it's been more fun.
The pandemic has caused all of us to come together in our little bubbles. And even at St. Paul Presbyterian Church, it's been hard to have to start during the pandemic, but I've also had the chance to visit individually with some members in ways that you just really know it's a privilege to come together, to love each other, and get to know one another.
Yeah.
And
I mean, we are getting to know each other. You know, I'm in the praise band.
Yes.
Yes. And, you know, we always need people. Tim's going to be out for the summer. So we would love to have some people come and join us at the praise band this summer. And we would love you to sing, play an instrument, those kind of things. We're always happy about it. And we do contemporary music if you haven't heard us before.
Yeah. Well, the praise band for St. Paul Presbyterian is just so gifted, and the ways through the years, it's just been a blessing. And then Calabash Choir just lifts and makes your spirit soar. And the choral choir, the rich history that they've had, and wanting to see all those styles of music to be blended. I just love the way St. Paul goes forward to say, we're going to honor all those traditions. And so it's been, in the last 5 months, it's been fun to be able to watch and learn about that as we've had to be virtual, and now we are in person. It's our 3rd Sunday coming up this Sunday, and we would love to have our members who feel ready to join us, bring a friend, visitors. We're beginning to have more and more freedom to gather and feel safe and to love on each other.
I love coming back. It was so fun. This, for the last 2 Sundays, we had people in the church. It was so wonderful. So I hope that you'll join us for another chat with Pastor Deb. And
come and have a cup of coffee and visit.
And we're hoping that we'll have other people besides me that would like to come and talk with her and get to know more about the different people in our church.